So we have a whipping action that's still not good enough, essentially. I have one more try at getting the physics, well, the animation that moves the whip, right, before I resort to some non-physical means, I suppose. But one.
And so that's what I do. Try a different way of moving his arm to see if that means the physics moves the whip better. And keep trying it. Every time I make a new physics animation, I have to import that animation into the scene to check that it works well when he walks as well. Works well when he walks as well. That's not a phrase you hear often. And we eventually get one that looks sort of alright, but none that I'm totally happy with. Occasionally render out OpenGL system view of the animation so that I can quickly test how well it looks when running at full speed. And here the blue whip is a new one constructed a different way, in the hope that having it straight at the beginning would help, but it doesn't, so I end up deleting all this and trying again. So we go back to starting with a bent whip and rebuild a new animation of him whipping. I have a quick go at doing a loop the loop with the whip to see if I can make it do something dramatic. See if moving it around in a circle will give a ribbon like trail.
Well, I suspect that's not really any better, but I'm going to render it and see, and have a think about other ways of doing a whip that aren't the cloth physics. We'll have a look.
And here we are looking. These whips aren't as bad as many of the others have been. I think it's probably the best one I've done. And having thought about doing it a different way, I've decided not to. That's as good as it's going to get. Come back next time.